Hello, this is Case Medlin with Range and Pasture. Back out in the field today, it's early December. Scouting the field for sandburs. Basically checking on those plants to see if we're actually battling a annual population of sandbur or we're battling a perennial population of sandbur. There's several different species of sandbur. Some of those can be perennials. Some of them can be short-lived perennials. Others are true annuals. So if you're truly interested in fighting sandbur and you want to get ahead of them, going to take a little bit of work. One thing you're going to have to do is get out in the field and monitor these plants to determine exactly what you have. What we need to be doing is getting back onto those places where we have thick sandbur, examining those plants starting in late December, carry that on into January and February. We're going to keep coming back to them. After we get through with some real cold nighttime temperatures where we have a sufficient, I guess, temperature to kill off any of the annual plants, we're going to start looking and seeing whether or not we've got any green coming back from any of those sandbur crowns and the lower stems, if we're putting on new leaves. Anything like that in late January or early February is going to tell us if we're dealing with some type of perennial plant. Maybe just a short-lived perennial. Maybe we don't get cold enough to kill it off. But regardless, Resilon by itself is not going to control those perennial plants, those coming back from the crowns from last year. Resilon is targeted towards killing those plants that are coming from seed and do an excellent job of controlling those. I'm going to give you a few pointers as far as how to determine whether or not you're fighting sandburs or looking at sandburs out in your field today. One is if you've got that inflorescence, that makes the work easy. Look at that inflorescence. If you've got the sandbur seed head there, 100%, you know what you have. If you've lost those burrs off of that inflorescence, off of that stem, take a look at the upper part of that stem where the seed head used to be. It is very distinctive. There's not a branch. It's just a single solitary stem, and the inflorescence sets at the top. You have a very jagged looking top of that where the actual sandburs used to actually attach to that seed head. With other grasses and their inflorescence, you typically have branches. That's the case with even Bermuda grass. It's typically branched. You're not going to have that jagged appearance at the top. When you get to something like large crabgrass, same thing. It's going to have several different branches coming off of that inflorescence at the top. Even if you move things like your native grasses, this is an example of KR bluestem. Same thing. The way that inflorescence is set up is totally different. So if you have the sandburs attached to the inflorescence, makes it easy to identify whether or not that's a sandbur plant. If you don't have the sandburs, look for that jagged appearance at the top of the stem where that inflorescence used to be. So get back out in your field, either mark or at least mark in your mind where those plants are located so that you can come back to them in January and February. At that time, we're going to split some of those stems open, some of those crowns open, and actually take a look and see whether or not we have any green tissue buried deep within that crown. At that time, you may actually see some green leaves coming out of those crowns. Then you know you have a perennial. To control those perennial plants, we're going to have a post-emergence herbicide that's applied, say, in April or May. We're not going to be very effective on that limited amount of green material that we have in January or February. But we still need to get a Resilon on the field because that means you still have a soil seed bank out there full of sandbur seed, and you're going to have to continue to control those with that late January, very early February application of Resilon. Hopefully, you're wrapping up any type of soil disturbance practices that you may have. If you're doing light tillage, some hay growers like to do that, give a little aeration, that kind of thing. If you have any aeration practices that you may implement in those fields, you need to get that wrapped up right away if you haven't already. Fluffy soil allows sandburs to germinate deeper within the soil profile. We need to give it time towards the last part of December and on into the new year for that soil to resettle, hopefully get a few rains on it, pack that soil back down so those sandburs can't germinate so deep within the soil profile. That is not in your favor. Resilon typically will not move that deep into the soil to control those that are germinating, say, 2+ inches deep in the soil profile. Hopefully if you're working on your sprayer and getting it ready, remember with Resilon, we'd like it ran with a boomed sprayer running flat fan nozzles. Fairly narrow row spacing, 20 inches preferably on your nozzle spacings there. Boomless sprayers are not optimum. The label actually says boom sprayers are not optimum. You don't get the coverage that you would like to have with Resilon. Think about it as trying to paint that soil surface with a paint or something like that. We actually need to keep that Resilon distributed evenly over that soil profile. Boomless spray rigs typically do not provide that. That's why we want to run a boom sprayer with flat fan nozzles. And we'll see you in the new season. Take care.